Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I will be showing you the result of my test for SD3.5 large model. Okay, so these are the different categories I've tested. So I've tested all the combination of samplers and schedulers. Plus, I've also tested what is the lowest step count that we can go to. I've also tested CFG and the model sampling. Now quickly, the way that you will read this is at the top here is the positive prompt, that is the text. On the right here above me are all the parameters which are fixed. Now one of these parameters will say question mark, and that is the one that I'm testing for this particular batch, and you will see the actual value for it at the bottom of each image. So for example, in this case we have sampler here as question mark, and then you can see that this image was generated with the sampler EULA, this one CFGPP, and then Ancestral here. Okay, so that's how you will read what you'll see on the screen. All right, so let's start. Right now I have the scheduler as normal, step count, CFG, the seed, all of that are fixed, and it's basically from the default workflow. I just drag, drop, and the only thing I've changed is the sampler here. So as you can see, EULA give positive result, same as yesterday's video. Now for the next batch, we have the Huon and then the PP2 version, which gives an actual image. Now DPM underscore 2 and the LMS gives result, but the DPM one changes to a different image. Now continuing with the DPM, the fast version did not give good result. The adaptive one, the usually for all these schedulers, they do give good result. And then the PP2S Ancestral gave me a good result here. Now moving on to the SDE, whether it's the normal one, the 2M or the 3M, the GPU or non-GPU, none of the DPM PP SDE worked. Now, of course, we already talked about the LCM. We don't have an LCM here. This IPN DM, I don't think it was in the previous video. Maybe they've added a new one, but this one gave a result. And on this batch, each one of these were a positive result, a good image that we can actually use. And then the Uni underscore PC and then the BH2 version, as yesterday's video, they gave a good result. So for this one, we actually have 14 usable image, compared to yesterday's video for the turbo version where we had only 8 usable image. Now quickly, I'm going to go through the other schedulers and samplers combination. So right now I've changed the scheduler to Keras, and then again we are going to test the samplers. So for Keras, the DPM adaptive gave a good result, and that's about it. Everything else is pretty much a bad image in some kind of way. So this is similar to yesterday's video for the turbo version where I said just avoid Keras, and similarly the exponential again falls under the same category. Again, same, you will see bad result with the exception of the DPM adaptive one, which gave kind of a usable result. All right, so now scheduler is SGM underscore uniform, and everything else is again fixed. This is going to be similar to the normal one. So as you can see, EULA works. We have the Huon, we have the DPM underscore 2, LMS, the adaptive one. Again, same thing, the SDE, regardless of the version, they do not work for this particular model. And then we have these three, and then these last two here. Now, similarly, the scheduler simple give the same result. So I'm just going to go through it really quickly. Now, DDIM underscore uniform, like yesterday, we basically get different images. So as you can see, like we still have the same thing that I've asked. We have desert, we have the clock, but it's different compared to the normal or the simple version. However, the same samplers that we talked previously, still they are the one that actually give an image. Now, the last scheduler that we have from the list is the beta, and this is similar to normal. So I'm just going to go through it. Now, even though I'm saying that it's similar to normal scheduler, it doesn't mean that you're going to get the same image. It just means that the same samplers which work for normal scheduler will also work for the beta scheduler. All right, next test that I've done is I fixed all of these parameters. So scheduler is at normal, sampler is at EULA, we have the model sampling at 3.0, CFG is at 4.5, and then we have the seed as fixed. And then what I'm changing here is the number of steps. So the first image was generated with 5 steps. So the turbo version can generate an image using 4 steps, but for the large version, you will need to have a little bit more number of steps. 5 is not enough, 10 as well is not enough, 15 as you can see is not enough, 20 we actually get an image, and then as you move on above it starts to become better and better. So 25, 30 we are still having the same composition, the image is changing slightly to adapt to the positive realm. Now when we move above 30 you can see now that the image is pretty much already completed. We have all the elements from the positive prime. Now we can keep going. So I went up to 60 steps, as you can see here. And from 50 to 60, there's barely any changes happening. So I think the sweet spot would be 40 as what was given to us from the default workflow. But you can go as low as 20. If you are trying to just get the composition and see if that's going to work. All right, next, I fixed the number of steps to 20, just so that I have faster generation. And then I'm going to change the CFG here. Everything else is fixed. So below 0, CFG does not really work. When you go above 1, we have 1.5, 2, and 2.5 did not work at all. Now starting from 3 onwards, it's able to get all the elements I'm asking. So since we are talking about CFG here, let's go through the positive prompt. I've asked for a desert with a clock. It should be buried in the sand. The hand should be frozen at midnight. Then should be some kind of scary type of atmosphere. The sky basically red, crimson red. So if we look at 3 here, we can see that the cloud basically the sky is starting to form, but it's not yet there. Increasing the CFG to 3.5, we can see now we're starting to see that crimson red color in the background. We have the clock, we have the desert. So moving on to the next batch, starting at 4.5 onwards, we can now see that we have desert, which has a little bit of color, and then the background as well, the sky is crimson red. Plus, we have the clock. We have a crack in the clock. The only thing that is missing here is the hands should be frozen at midnight. So I think that's going to be a little bit difficult for the AI to generate. But otherwise, we have pretty much all the elements. Now, from these, I think that 5 here gave good result when it comes to the tree. However, we can see that if the CFG is a little bit too high, the crack that was in the clock start to change into some kind of bushes or like dry grass or something. And you can see here when we go to 5.5, it's pretty much like branches coming out. If you keep on pushing the CFG and maybe you can pay attention to the shadows here of the tree, 6 higher, you can see that now we are starting to lose a little bit. It's not like this as sharp and starting to become softer, but it's able to get this part here where we have the clock, which is supposed to be half buried in the sand. So there's a trade-off when increasing the CFG. Obviously, it's going to try to follow the prompt. Now I've gone all the way until 10 and above 7.5, I'll say above 6.5, we we don't get good results. So I would stay below. For this one, I think I prefer the 4.5, but I prefer the individual LMS like the tree from the CFG5 one. So 4.5 is a good average to try out. And if you're not able to get all the elements in the image, you can try to increase it to 5.5 and see if you're able to get all the elements there. All right, so last we have the model sampling. And we have an image here. When you set the model sampling to 0, we just get black image. Now below 1 doesn't really work. Below 3, I'll say don't go below 3. Now starting at 3 is where we get that image. So 3 was the default in the workflow. Now if we go to 3.5, 4, we start to get, in my opinion, a slightly better result. So in here we can see that the background is plain, but at 4 we have something in the background. And I went all the way until 5, as you can see here. So this is also a good option to experiment and to maybe push a little bit or decrease a little bit. For this one, I think at 4 gave a really good result. All right, so that's all the tests that I have for today for this model, Stable Diffusion 3.5 large. Let me know if you have anything else that you want me to test for. If you have your own test results, so for CFG, StepScout, Scheduler, let me know in the comments down below what works best for you, and I can give it a try and see what kind of result I get. All of these images will be in the description below. Simply look for any of the comfyui_00 and pick anyone, select it, drag it on top of comfyui, let go, and you will get the workflow. All right, so thank you for watching until the very end. Have a nice day ahead. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.